Thou mastering me, God, giver of breath and bread, world strand, sway of the sea, Lord of living and dead. Thou hast bound bones and veins in me, fastened me flesh, and after it almost unmade, what with dread thy doing. And dost thou touch me afresh? Over again I feel thy finger and find thee. I did say yes, O at lightning and lashed rod. Thou heardst me truer than tongue confess thy terror, O Christ, O God. Thou knowest the walls, altar, and hour and night, the swoon of a heart that the sweep and the hurl of thee trod hard down with a horror of height, and the midriff a strain with leaning of, laced with fire of stress, the frown of his face before me, the hurtle of hell behind. Where was a place? I whirled out wings that spell, and fled with a fling of the heart to the heart of the host. My heart, but you were dove-winged, I can tell. Carrier-witted, I am bold to boast, to flash from the flame to the flame then, tower from the grace to the grace. I am soft sift in an hourglass, at the wall fast, but mind with emotion adrift, and it crowds and it combs to the fall. I steady as a water in a well, to a poise, to a pain, but roped with always, all the way down from the tall fells or flanks of the vole, a vein of the gospel proffer, a pressure, a principle, Christ's gift. I kiss my hand to the stars, lovely asunder, starlight, wafting him out of it, and glow, glory in thunder. Kiss my hand to the dappled with dams and west, since though he is under the world's splendor and wonder, his mystery must be in stressed, for I greet him the days I meet him, and bless when I understand. Not out of his bliss springs the stress felt, nor first from heaven, and few know this, swings the stroke dealt. Stroke under stress that stars and storms deliver, that guilt is hushed by, hearts are flushed by and melt. But it rides time like riding a river, and here the faithful waver, the faithless fable and miss. It dates from day of his going in Galilee, warm-laid grave of a womb-life grey, manger, maiden's knee, the dense and the driven passion and frightful sweat, thence the discharge of it, there its swelling to be, though felt before, though in high flood yet, what none would have known of it, only the heart, being hard at bay, is out with it. Oh, we lash with the best or worst word last. How a lush-kept, plush-capped slow will mouthed to flesh burst gush. Flush the man, the being with it, sour or sweet, brim in a flash full. Hither then, last or first, to hero of Calvary, Christ's feet. Never ask if meaning it, wanting it, warned of it, men go. Be adored among men, God three-numbered form, ring thy rebel, dogged in den man's malice with wrecking and storm, beyond saying sweet, past telling of tongue, thou art lightning and love, I found it, a winter and warm. Father and fondler of heart thou hast wrung, hast thy dark descending, and most art merciful then. With an anvil ding, and with fire in him forge thy will, or rather than stealing as spring through him, melt him but master him still. Whether at once, as once at a crash, Paul, or as Austin, a lingering out sweet skill, make mercy in all of us, out of us all, mastery, but be adored. But be adored, King. Some find me a sword, some the flange and the rail, flame, fang, or flood, goes death on drum, and storms bugle his fame. But we dream we are rooted in earth, dust. Flesh falls within sight of us, we, though our flower the same, wave with the meadow, forget that there must the sour scythe cringe, and the blear share come. On Saturday sailed from Bremen, American outward bound, take settler and seamen, tell men with women, 200 souls in the round. O Father, not under thy feathers, nor ever as guessing, the goal was a shoal, of a fourth the doom to be drowned. Yet did the dark side of the bay of thy blessing not vault them, the millions of rounds of thy mercy not reeve even them in. Into the snows she sweeps, hurling the haven behind, the Deutschland on Sunday, and so the sky keeps, for the infinite air is unkind, and the sea flint flake black-backed in the regular blow, sitting east-north-east in cursed quarter the wind, wiry and white, fiery and whirlwind, swiveled snow, spins to the widow-making, unchilding, unfathering deeps. She drove in the dark to leeward. She struck not a reef or a rock, but the combs of a smother of sand. Night drew her, dead, to the Kentish knock. And she beat the bank down with her bows and the ride of her keel. The breakers rolled on her beam with ruinous shock, and canvas and compass, the haul and the wheel, idle forever to waft her or wind her with. These she endured. Hope had grown grey hairs, hope had mourning on, trenched with tears, carved with cares, hope was 12 hours gone. And frightful a nightfall folded, rueful a day, nor rescue, only rocket and lightship shone, and lives at last were washing away, to the shrouds they took, they shook in the hurling and horrible airs. One stirred from the rigging to save the wild womankind below. With a rope's end round the man, handy and brave, he was pitched to his death at a blow, for all his dreadnought breast and braids of thew. They could tell him for hours, dandled the to and fro, through the cobbled foam fleece, what could he do with the burl of the fountain of air, buck and the flood of the wave? They fought with God's cold, and they could not, and fell to the deck, crushed them, or water, and drowned them, or rolled with the sea romp over the wreck. Night roared with the heartbreak, hearing a heartbroke rabble, the woman's wailing, the crying of child without check, till a lioness arose, breasting the babble. A prophetess towered in the tumult, a virginal tongue told. Ah, touched in your bower of bone, are you? Turn for an exquisite smart, have you? Make words break from me here all alone, do you? Mother of being in me, heart, oh, unteachably after evil, but uttering truth, why, tears, is it? Tears? Such a melting, a magical start, never eldering revel and river of youth. What can it be, this glee, the good you have there of your own? Sister, a sister calling, a master, her master and mine, and the inboard seas run swirling and hauling, the rash smart sloggering brine blinds her, but she that weather sees one thing, one, has one fetch in her. She rears herself to divine ears, and the call of the tall nun to the men in the tops and the tackle rode over the storms brawling. She was first of a five and came of a coiffed sisterhood. O Deutschland, double a desperate name, O world wide of its good. But Gertrude, Lily, and Luther are two of a town, Christ's lily and beast of the waste wood. From life's dawn it is drawn down, Abel is Cain's brother, and breasts they have sucked the same. Loathed for a love men knew in them, banned by the land of their birth, Rhine refused them, Thames would ruin them, surf, snow, river, and earth gnashed. But thou art above, thou Orion of light. Thy unchancelling, poising palms were weighing the worth, thou martyr master. In thy sight, storm flakes were scroll-leaved flowers, lily showers, sweet heaven was astrew in them. 5. The finding and sake and cipher of suffering Christ. Mark, the mark is of man's make and the word of it sacrificed. But he scores it in scarlet himself on his own bespoken, before time taken, dearest prized and priced, stigma, signal, cinquefoil token, for lettering of the lamb's fleece, ruddying of the rose flake. Joy fall to thee, Father Francis, drawn to the life that died, with the gnarls of the nails in the niche of the lance, his lovescape crucified, and seal of his seraph arrival, and these thy daughters, and 5 livid and leavèd, favour and pride, are sisterly sealed in wild waters to bathe in his fall-gold mercies, to breathe in his all-fire glances. Away in the lovable west, on a pastoral forehead of Wales, I was under a roof here, I was at rest, and they the prey of the gales. She to the black about air, to the break of the thickly falling flakes, to the throng that catches and quails, was calling, O Christ, Christ, come quickly. The cross to her she calls, Christ to her, christens her wild worst, best. The majesty, what did she mean? Breathe, arch and original breath. Is it love in her of the being as her lover had been? Breathe. Body of lovely death. They were else-minded then altogether. The men woke thee whither. We are perishing in the weather of Gennesareth. Or is it that she cried for the crown then, the keener to come at the comfort, for feeling the combating keen? For how to the heart cheering, the down-dugged, ground-hugged grey hovers off, the jay-blue heavens appearing of pied and peeled May, blue-beating and hoary glow height, or night still higher with belled fire and the moth-soft Milky Way. What by your measure is the heaven of desire? The treasure never eyesight got, nor was ever guessed what for the hearing? No, but it was not these, the jading and jar of the cart. Time's tasking it is, fathers, that asking for ease of the sodden with its sorrowing heart. Not danger, electrical horror. Then further, it finds the appealing of the passion is tenderer in prayer apart. Other, I gather, in measure her mind's burden, in winds burly and beat of endragoned seas. But how shall I make me room there, reach me a fancy come faster, strike you the sight of it, look at it loom there, thing that she, there then, the master, ipse, the only one, Christ, king, head, he was to cure the extremity where he had cast her, do, deal, lord it with living and dead. Let him ride her pride in his triumph, dispatch and have done with his doom there. Ah, there was a heart right, there was single eye, read the unshapable shot night, and knew the who and the why. Wording it how but by him that present and past, heaven and earth are word of, worded by. The Simon Peter of a soul, to the blast, tapé and fast, but a blown beacon of light. Jesu, heart's light, Jesu, made sun, what was the feast, followed the night, thou hadst glory of this nun? Feast of the one woman without stain, for so conceived, so to conceive thee is done. But here was heart-throw, birth of a brain, word that heard and kept thee and uttered thee outright. Well, she has thee for the pain, for the patience, but pity of the rest of them. Heart, go and bleed at a bitterer vein for the comfortless unconfessed of them. No, not uncomforted. lovely felicitous providence, finger of a tender of, oh, of a feathery delicacy, the breast of the maiden could obey so, be a bell to ring of it and startle the poor sheep back. Is the shipwreck then a harvest? Does tempest carry the grain for thee? I admire thee, master of the tides, of the yore flood, of the year's fall, the recurb and the recovery of the gulf's sides, the girth of it and the wharf of it and the wall, stanching, quenching ocean of a motionable mind, ground of being and granite of it, past all, grasp God, throned behind death with a sovereignty that heeds but hides, bodes but abides, with a mercy that outrides the all of water, an ark for the listener, for the lingerer with a love glides lower than death and the dark. A vein for the visiting of the past prayer, pent in prison, the last breath penitent spirits, the uttermost mark our passion plunged giant risen, the Christ of the Father compassionate fetched in the storm of his strides. Now burn, newborn to the world, double natured name, the heaven flung, heart fleshed, maiden furled, miracle in Mary of flame, mid-numbered he in three of the thunder throne, not a doomsday dazzle in his coming, nor dark as he came, kind but royally reclaiming his own. A released shower let flash to the shire, not a lightning of fire, hard hurled. Dame at our door, drowned, and among our shoals, remember us in the roads, the heaven haven of the reward. Our king back, oh, upon English souls. Let him Easter in us, be a day spring to the dimness of us, be a crimson cresseted east, more brightening her rare dear Britain, as his reign rolls, pride rose, prince, hero of us, high priest, our heart's charities, hearth's fire, our thoughts chivalries, throngs, lord,